Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps with TensorFlow. We will see how to work with spacy models. Additionally, we will look how to train our personal NERV model with our own data. As usual, I have created a notebook that later on I will post to the repository that you will be able to replicate in your local environment. Today I'm working in Colab Pro. Well, we don't need the GPU in this case. You can use it with the spacey models, but today the size of the model that we are going to train is not very big, and it's not going to be necessary to do it to use the GPU. But just to let you know that you can do it. For those that they are not familiar with Spacy is an NLP, pure NLP library. It's already on the market for a number of years. To my mind, probably 8 years ago, I start to know about this wonderful library. Replace completely NLTK, that was probably the oldest one, and today, correct me if you are wrong, but in my opinion, is one for this specific matter is one is the best NLP library that you had on the market, at least in Python. You had other libraries like from to work in Spark, like Snow Labs from or in Java. You had different NLP libraries, but in Python, I think as conventional NLP library is the best one that you have. It's very fast, it covers a lot of the languages. We will look at the languages we have on the video as well. It's really, really good, the library, and again, it's already mature, many people using it on the industry, and well, very stable, and you can do a lot of stuff with this library without the need to use a transformers. Today with transformers probably is a little bit cornered, because obviously the power of transformers and large language models is enormous, and then it's very difficult to compete with that. But this is really efficient library that you can use for many things, and you don't need to go to the complexity or the load an LLM, and it's for many NLP tasks is really something that you need to consider, because it's doing the job very efficiently, and as I said, in many languages. As you can see here, there is some languages that they have different. This is a pre-trained models which have come in different formats. The models essentially is a pipeline, you can make a simile like a transformers pipeline with this a tokenizer and different components which essentially take a document and enrich the document with multiple tags like lemmas, post, ner, spans, where the next token, previous token, etc., etc. So there is two different kind of tokenizers: the pure, in quotas, spacey tokenizer with its token to back, and also especially the most common models come as well with a tokenizer in that is a BERT transformer, Roberta transformer in this case. That is the tokenizer, the initial components which tokenize the document. So, as I said, Spacy essentially is a pipeline with different components. You take, you input a text, and this text passes sequentially through different components, and each component is enriching what we know in Spacy doc. A doc is a type. It's a class which essentially contains all the document, the text, and all the metadata that we generate with these components. Where is this exactly? The components you have here, all these links are in the notebook. You can take a look later. So all the NLPD models contains a tokenizer. By default is a talk to back tokenizer. Let me cast as bad memory sometime. Talk to back, exactly, tokenizer, and the rest are if you take a pre-trained model, we will look at this, you know, it comes additionally with tagger, parser, ner, and lemmatizer, and text categorizer, and custom obviously are optional. Custom is for whatever that is not including here, and you want to do with your tokens, doc, or spans, you can do it with a custom component. And text categorizer is to assign labels to the documents, like for example span, no span, or you want to do, to classify the document versus multiple categories, etc. You can train a model specifically with your data, something similar to what we are going to do today in this video. And well, you usually use either you take one of these components and you train it with your own data, or you can this is a component level of the pipeline, and also you can take a document level and use the text categorizer to train a model in English, in Italian, in German, whatever language, and classify your document versus the logic that you implement on this text categorization. And again, you can do the same custom component, which essentially can do whatever you consider necessary to do that is not included here, no, and it's not can be derivative from something of the native functionality that Spacey has. Again, we have multiple languages which are fully supported with multiple pre-trained pipelines, and there is another which are just contains the stop tokens and sometimes the tokenizer, but those languages are still in development. You can use it as a base to build your own model, but you will have to do, for example, you take this Persian, for example, you may need to create different, you have different components, but the model is not complete. You may need to, you try to download it. You can check later which components you had already created in Spacey, but you may need to to design your component you may need, for example, you have here the Stop Wars, Lex. Yeah, it's some of the, you have some components, but you don't have a lexicon. Yeah, this is, you may need to create your own components just to complete or to get the same level of the detail that you get with a complete model like the ones that you had here. So for those that they don't have pipeline, pre-trained pipeline, you may need to create many of the components. But in any case, you can see here this has most of them are not very used language for countries which are local languages in some cases. Yeah. Okay, so the thing is that those languages, you can download the model directly like a Python package and start to use it very simple, as you will see on the notebook. The other ones you will need to code yourself practically the whole pipeline if you want to create a model. There is a big community at the same time. These models are the official models. There is many people who is working on their own personal models or in their own language model that you may find and extended or use it, because again there is also a huge hub of developers who are working in with this with spacing. Okay, sorry, excuse me, but it was an interruption. Okay, let's move to the notebook, and then we can look at the different details now when we are covering the notebook. Okay, so we install the, if you are working in a notebook, in a Colab notebook, you don't need to install a spacing. You may need to install additional models, as you will see here. I will show you how to do it as well. And you need to install MRflow and well, PyNGRK to just tunnel the MRflow UI to see it in internet, to see what we produce with MRflow. Here we just simply import what we need. We are running MRflow UI on the on Google Colab. We are tunneling here, importing from spacing, and well, you just create a text. Here, the basic one is create a model in blank for a specific language. This is what usually you will do in those languages that you don't have a pipeline. And here you have, you don't have components. Oh, sorry, this is because it's still the training. You don't have components, so you don't have anything here. Exactly, you don't have here, except the tokenizer, you don't have target parser there. So you can take a look to the config of the model, and then it, even if you take the tokenizer, it's gonna be NLP, NLP tokenizer. Yeah, you have a tokenizer, the spacey, the talk to back tokenizer, native from, in this case, from designed by Spacey, and the rest is, well, the default parameters of some model. You can convert the text in a spacey document, and we're here. You don't have many attributes apart from the ones that you generate with the tokenizer. If you take a look to the type of what is doc, it's a spicy document. Okay. And for example, there is no sentences, there is nothing, because we don't have components in our pipeline. This is an empty component. The only thing that you have on the pipeline is essentially the tokenizer, the rest it doesn't exist. So we just pass the text to the tokenizer and there is no enrichment. We just convert the text into a spacey doc, object. So now we are going to use a pre-trained pipeline. It's English. Small, there is different size of models. Let me show you in English. I think we saw before packages. We had the small, the medium, the large. You had the size on the description, the components as well. And you had also the transformers. They are different in between this and the other three. Is that the tokenizer here in these three, the small, medium, and large, is a talk-to-back component, an embedded layer. And here we have a transformer, a Roberta tokenizer here. So you can see here what we have. There is a description of everything that you have in every pipeline. So if we load, if you don't have a model, you can download this one. It is the transformer. You will need to download it before with this sentence, as you can see here. Any model, any pre-trained pipeline, you just need to localize the label and you can download it like this. Probably you need to, if you are working in a notebook like me, you need to, you will need to reboot the notebook and run it again, no? The Encore Web SM is already there, so you just can take a look what do you have. Talk to be tagger, parser, attribute ruler, lemmatizer and ner. If you take the Encore Web Transformer, you will see that the only thing that changes is the transformer itself. It's you take a look to the config and here blah 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 curated transformer Roberta transformer, exactly. Yeah, this is the model with our It's not exactly the same that you have in Hugging Face. The architecture obviously the same, but is kind of curated, no? As they say in the name, by Spacey too, and everything not adapted, but well, they make it work together in few words, no? With the spans tagger. So, and when you have a transformer, you can see that everything is adapted. That's why I'm saying that it's adapted to the transformer technology. Okay. So you can now with the, this is the talk to back, the small spacing model in English, and you can see here now when you use a pipeline, obviously the text, the document is already enriched with everything that you can produce using the different components that you that had the pipeline, like posts, lemmas, spans, whatever is producing these components. Obviously, depending on the size of the model, is more how to say powerful than the. Is due to the number of tokens. If you take a look to the descriptions, for example, the large is the only one that had the vectors, also the transformers. Ah, no, they already included. No, exactly. In the small ones, there is no vectors. You cannot calculate cosine similarity, for example, in between two different documents. Here, the medium has already 20k unique vectors. And here, yeah, is including vectors as well with 300 dimension. And the transformers is not including vectors as well, so you cannot calculate with transformers directly. So when I say that you can calculate cosine similarity, if you had two documents, you pass them, you create a spacey doc with this model, then you can do dot one similarity dot two, and you will get a coefficient of the cosine similarity in between these two documents, because this when you create a document, when you pass through this model a text document, is producing as well a vector which represents the document itself, and then this way you later is a vector of 300 dimensions. It's done with the tokenizer, and then on the later you can use this model this vector to calculate the similarity in between documents. Okay, so as I said, once you had a pipeline with components, you can produce and enumerate what spacey detected. You can do as well with the transformer. The transformer hat in this case is a little bit poor in comparison with the spacey model. Terms of the pos is producing exactly the same num space num. Number, no, exactly. Okay. Now we are going to start to work with Emmerflow. Emmerflow is or spaces natively integrated with Tamerflow. So there is a flavor in Spacy. Here we can use as well the Python model, but we will need to adapt many things if we want to use later for inference the Python model. Why? Because the Python model was designed to do predictions, and usually with the spatial library you don't do predictions, you don't do inference, you just simply pass a text through the pipeline and you get a document with a lot of metadata, with metadata which you can later use in NLP activities. You can obviously create a text categorizer. You can use these components and produce labels for documents, which is a kind of prediction. No? Here we can train a model and assign different labels to a document. After passing for this categorization, this is a kind of inference, but the way we need to prepare a custom model before we will be able to use this test categorization. This is a component that we need to train. So I will try to prepare something in order to show how this works, but it's not the integration that we had is only, how to say, directly if we use the spacey flavor. We cannot use here directly like in other technologies the Python model or the PyFAM. So here to set a model, we just take the model English small and we just simply serialize it to the artifact repository with the spacey flavor, lock the model we want to lock, and the repository. So if you go now to Emmerflow, this is our model, and you can see here what we have. We have the metadata of the model, all the components of our spacey model, ruler, lemmatizer, NER, parser, sentencer, tagger, token to be vocabulary. This is tokenizer here. And you have your model card, your environment, in Conda, in Python, and your requirement TST. So essentially the same that you have for other technologies, but this here with the particularity that is a NLP library, which is slightly different from the other ones that we used to work with. And here, if you want to, this is the model URI, the location of the, and if you want to download the model and use it simply like we did with other in other videos, you just take the, in this case the flavor, not the PyFAM, and you just take the model and you pass the text through the model exactly the same like you did before, and you have here the entities, the NER, and here it has the pods, exactly the same. Now we are going to next exercise, we will train our NER NER detection model. We are going to create a model in blank just with the tokenizer, and we will just add a NER component and we will train this with our own data. So we load the model and we prepare some training data. Training models in NLP is quite tedious because you have to prepare the data. Maybe you can, maybe not, practically sure we can create some synthetic data using a large language model. It shouldn't be very difficult using GPT-4 or Gemini together with a LangChain. We can generate this structure very easily. is not you need to use an annotation tool like this. I put you some links here on the notebook. These two. Prodigy is a tool that you need to have a license, and Techoholic is not is free, but in any case, both of them are quite so. Tagging the data is quite tedious. And then on here, I make a test. You just need to, for example, let me check if there is I don't know. Let's check here. This not remove it. You just need here to go one by one and tagging the here we have selected this tag. You can add new tags. You have to go in the document and tag your data, and it's quite tedious and in many cases prone to error. But okay, there is no other way. Again, you can generate synthetic data. And once you had your data, Prodigy is very similar. It has some automatizations. But of course, you need to pay for that. You need to create it like this. How many examples per tag? 50. Probably less, depending on the number of tags that you want to localize in your text. But yeah, in any case, this is again the most tedious part of this activity. So here I just create some examples how you have to create the data is your text and then on a dictionary with the entities that you want to recognize. Here person, location. Here I define person in Prodigy. The conventional entities, NER entities, are already defined. And then on, you can create as well your custom entities, like I did here, profession, which it doesn't exist in most of the NER models. And then here I create profession and title, Mr. in this case, like additional NER entities. You create your train data, we create our experiment, and here the training, we are training a component in this case. You can train, as I said, any of these components. All of them can be trained, except the tokenizer, obviously, the tagger, parser, NER, lemmatizer, text classifier. This component can be trained as well with your own data, and obviously the custom component. All of them can be trained. Under the hood, this is using neural networks, and concretely PyTorch. And we are reducing the loss via gradient descent. The only thing that we need to do here is we're just define the parameters of the training. We just set this into a Emberflow experiment. You can start using Emberflow commands, and your training data had to be transformed into docs, into spacey docs. So we just use make docs method of our NLP model, and then on we just use the annotations. The annotations is we are dividing the every single record in text and annotation, which are the entities. So we just create with the this is another class example, and then we create examples which we add into a list of examples. Every example is done with spacey documents plus the entities recognized. And then you initialize the model with the examples that you just created, start the training, and here is just the conventional training. We are just iterating through 100 iterations in this case We shuffle the data. We have here a dictionary for losses, and then we pass our data in batches, like in the training of any conventional neural network. There is a method update where we pass the batch and the losses that we had during this epoch. And then we are logging here the losses, and finally we log the training model to MLflow. Let's run it, and then it's gonna take some seconds. It's very fast. The model is very, very simple and not many training data, so it's gonna be very fast. So let's go here, trainer. So we had you had our parameters, your metrics. Here you have the loss. Let's exactly, yeah, nothing. And the artifacts, as you will see here, only an error and the tokenizer, the vocabulary obviously, and the metadata. So here, as you can see, we don't have the other components that we have in the pre-trained pipelines. But the way that we use it is exactly the same that we use it with the previous one or with any other library that we use integrated with MLflow. Now the model was logged into this model URI, which is here in this run, and you can load it with the spacey flavor again, and you can, well, here we are just passing our model, our text through the new model, and we are localizing the labels, the entities. So for every entity, we print the text and the label of that text. So well, it's normal that the model was successful in everything, and then the tokens as well. We are printing the tokens and the entities that we recognize. Who is Nissan? Entities, Mr. Taigo, Mr. Tokens, Mr. Taigo is a engineer. So here we are just printing the entity type, the text, and the entity EOB. And you can see here that we only had a component in our pipeline, which is the NERV model. So I will try to prepare a more complex example. The idea of the video was not show you how to work with SPICY, it's how to work in MLflow like any other library. I wanted to show you some of the functionalities that we can do, because the idea of this series of videos is how we can work with multiple libraries and all of them in a common framework, which is MLflow, which help us to work with any kind of model. And case that the model that we want to use is not integrated with natively with MLflow, we can create our custom model and adapt it to the MLflow framework. Here, as I said, NLP with this library is not exactly the same that we do with others, like a conventional XGBoost or a neural network. Here we are doing something a little bit different. We will do something more similar to what we usually do with a deep learning model when we train a classifier here, and then you will see when we try a categorizer, it's a classifier. All of these are essentially classifiers. When you are personalizing your NERV component, you are training a classifier as well. But yeah, the way that the NLP library spacey work is slightly different, and then that's why we cannot use the PY full model, because you need to define an inference, a predict method, which is the one that is common to all of the libraries. And in this case, when in spacey, we don't have a predict itself. And unless that you create a TextCat component. If you don't have this component or a custom with essentially also create some labels, some additional label attributes to the text, it will not be any, we'll say, prediction. So that's why we are not using it here in this example. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it, or you find it interesting and useful for your training and your job. And if it is like that, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and share with your friend and colleagues just to help me to promote my channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. Bye bye.